He's Travis.
He's Jonathan.
Sit back, relax, and join the fun.
He's Jonathan.
He's Travis. When they're on TV, they'll have us mesmerized. Can't believe your eyes.
They'll take the prize from those other guys. There are a million things that they could be.
Like a cobbler.
Or a Mormon. Or a sassafras tree. But they're so darn entertaining. We think, well, they're on TV.
It's the Travis and Jonathan Show.
Get ready, get set to learn a thing or two.
At the mall, at the courthouse, at the campus, or the zoo.
There's so many things that they might do.
Get your kids out of bed so they can watch it too. They'll win your heart. They'll make you smile.
So watch their show. It's worth your while.
It's the Travis and Jonathan Show.
Jonathan Chokley, Travis Harlan, Jonathan and Travis, Travis and Jonathan.
Here's the show, watch
it. Now
it's time to start the show.
Okay, Jonathan. You ready to start this puppy off?
I guess so, Travis.
I'm in the mood for a little old-time rock and roll. How about you?
Yeah, that'd be fun. Risky Business.
That's right. That was a great movie.
It was.
You know, they're divorced, but that Moulin Rouge looks really good.
I hope so.
Let me start this off, okay?
Okay.
I was a little too tall, could have used a few pounds. Tight pants, points, hardly renowned. She was a black-haired beauty with big dark eyes. And points all her own, sitting way up high.
Way up burning
high. Out past the cornfields where the woods got heavy. Out in the backseat of my 60 Chevy. Working on mysteries without any clues. Working on our night moves. Working on night moves. Trying to make some front page driving news. Working on our night moves. When was that, Jonathan?
I think it was in the summertime.
Had a sweet, sweet summertime.
Summertime.
Sweet, sweet, sweet summertime.
We weren't in love. Oh, no. Far from it. We were not searching for some pie in the sky sun. We were just young and restless, and we were bored.
Living by the sword.
What? I don't know what that means.
I don't either. I don't.
And we'd steal away every chance we could get.
We could.
To the back room, to the alley, or the trusty woods.
I used her,
and she used me.
But neither one cared.
We were.
Getting our share!
Working on our night moves.
Trying to lose those our teenage blues.
Working on our night moves.
Yeah. You remember when that was, don't you?
Summertime.
Summertime, that's right. Summertime's great. I like autumn better, though.
What's that?
I just like autumn. It's, I like it when things turn brown, like when I put the muffins in, they turn brown the leaves. You know, autumn is just...
That's interesting.
It's not.
Oh, the wonder. Felt the lightning, waited on the thunder,
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 waited on the thunder.
I woke last night to the sound of thunder. How far off, I sat and wondered.
Started humming a song from 1962.
Oh, I love that movie. Wait, what am I thinking?
That is Summer of 41.
Oh.
That's when the boy...
Oh, that's a good
time,
one, though.
I know. Right. He was so embarrassed when we went to the store and he couldn't...
Ain't it funny how the night moves? We just don't seem to have as much to lose. Strange how the night moves.
With autumn closing in.
Yeah,
I didn't even know that was the last
one. We're reading these. I don't know. We have our lyric sheets in front of us.
I got mine here. I might need
Well, because we're doing it on the phone,
well,
so we don't really need to.
But Jesus. I guess we just...
Are we doing it now?
Well, hang on. What are you doing? E?
Try it.
Ah.
Night moves. Working on our night moves. Hey, working on our night moves.
Night moves, night moves, night moves.
Night moves, night moves,
night moves.
Moving in the night, moving in the night, moving in the night, moving in the night, night moves.
Hey,
okay.
Wait, it just clicked out.
Oh,
okay.
Is that it?
Can you hit stop?
Hi, everybody. I'm Jonathan Shockley, and I'm here at the hospital with Travis's niece. You may notice that I'm not there in person. I'm on speakerphone.
I'm on speakerphone, too, because I thought you were going to be there earlier.
Travis, where are you?
I know I'm late. I'm on the way.
Okay, good. We had our dates mixed up.
Let's do the show real quick.
Right, the show must go on.
But today the show, that's right, we're on the phones.
Right, and we have a very special show. We have a very special musical guest.
I'm excited about it.
It's going to be an incredible show just because we're not there in person.
What do you say, Jonathan? What you want to jump into it right now? Let's just start the show.
Sure, let's start the show.
On the phones, because it's different.
On the phone show. Okay.
I know.
Well, here we go.
Well, you want to start it right now?
How about,
No, let's go ahead and just go into it, and let's have a good time. This is a phone show.
He's Travis.
He's Jonathan.
Sit back, relax, and join the fun.
Jonathan.
He's Travis.
When they're on TV, they'll have us.
Mesmerized, can't believe your eyes. They'll take the prize from those other guys. There are a million things that they could be.
Like a cobbler.
Or a Mormon.
Or a sassafras tree. But they're so darn entertaining. They think, well, they're on TV. It's the Travis and Jonathan Show.
Get ready, get set to learn a thing or two.
At the mall, at the courthouse, at the campus, or the zoo.
There's so many things that they might do.
Get your kids out of bed so they can watch it too. They'll win your heart. They'll make you smile.
So watch their show. It's worth your while.
It's the Travis and Jonathan Show.
Jonathan Chappman,
Travis Harmon, Jonathan and Travis, Travis and Jonathan.
Here's the show, watch it.
Boy, I'm so excited about
this show. This show's going to be great, even though it just because it's phones. It's going to be great.
Phone doesn't mean it's bad.
I hate to interrupt.
Hey, everybody, it's Craig Davidson.
It is.
Well, certainly dure. As I say in French, I've got just a super great tape here that I want you to see. It's a must-do, have to see.
Was it like a clip?
A clip you brought us?
I have a great clip for you that's just beats everything you've ever seen.
Just great. Couldn't
that's
be better.
Terrific. It's great. Hey. Have you been feeling okay?
Super great. Just excellent.
So you're okay.
Yeah.
Well, good. Yeah. What's this clip you've got to show us? What's the movie?
Baby Secret of the Lost Legend. You've got
to Baby Secret of the Lost Legend.
Yes, do want to show you a clip here. Let me show it to you. Hang on just a second.
Okay.
Look at it on the screen here.
I can hardly wait, Travis.
Craig is popping up for us.
Right. I've never seen that movie.
Let's see what it looks like. Shh. Can you be quiet? Shh.
Oh, baby. You don't belong to me.
Guys,
it was amazing!
It was great.
I can hardly wait to rent that.
It was a great clip.
I've seen it on really shelves, but I've never rented it.
It looked... I haven't seen the movie before.
We've got a segment coming out with Chef Marquis.
Chef Marquis.
He is a chef. He's been at 4-star restaurants, and we have all the ingredients.
You should stay and have a bite or two with us.
Craig, won't you stay and have dinner with us? This food is going to be amazing. I mean, it'll melt in your mouth.
Good.
Well, I've got... Sorry, I can't stay, guys. I've got to go, really. This tape here, I've got late fees just piling up on me big time from this rental store, and I've got to get this back. So,
Craig, you may want to rethink this.
Because I mean, this food's going to be great. Chef Marquis is quite a cook, quite a chef.
You've never put anything like this in your mouth before, and I can guarantee.
Well, first of all, I don't like eating raw bacon because of the open parasites it'll give me. But it does smell good anyway, and I appreciate you people inviting me. I sure
now,
do.
Now, Craig, I have to say that we're not going to serve you raw bacon.
No,
we'll get something else.
Right, we're not going to serve you bacteria.
No one would eat bacteria.
No, you're really going to enjoy this.
No, this is going to be good food. It's going to be healthy food.
Get a plate, sit down, get your napkin out.
Have a good time with this.
A knife?
Please, enjoy.
And I bet you it'll taste delicious. But for real, guys, I've got just minutes. I'm down on just minutes and seconds now to get this back to the store before I get into the late charge, and I cannot afford one, so I must run. But I appreciate you people inviting me anyway.
Craig, are you...
Care.
Craig, wait one second, though. I couldn't hear you.
The plane flight, yes, sir. Okay, wait, guys, okay. I'd love to get this back. I'd love to stay to eat with you, man. I'd just super like to do that. But I've got to get this back to the video store because of one thing.
Mm-hmm.
Late fees. Okay, they're piling up on me already. I've got a bunch of them on me, which are old money. And I've got to get it back immediately. I'm down to minutes and seconds now. I've got to get this back. So please excuse me. I must run, for real. Take
care.
See
you later.
Good to see you.
Well, thanks for stopping by, Craig.
Okay, bye, Craig. Thanks for stopping by.
Bye, Craig. We'll see you later. That was great. That was a great clip.
It was a great clip.
Okay, so, Chef Marquis, what are you going to make for us today?
I'm going to prepare delicious vegetables on there for you today. It's very easy to make, and it tastes great.
Vegetable lasagna sounds terrific.
So I trust you have all your ingredients out there, even though
we can't see them.
Right, because we're on the phone.
it's very unusual, but I understand the show must go on, so yes, I do have all the ingredients here.
So what do we need to do first here?
Well, the first thing we are going to do is take a tomato, an onion, cut them in half, and put them into the food processor, which we set on puree, and then you just puree your burger. And then you... wait a minute here. Still a little pulpy. Take care of that here now. Mm-hmm. All right. Then you take out a mixing bowl and mixer, and you put in your stewed peeled tomato.
And this is for?
This is for the creamy potato-based filling.
Oh, for the...
Right, for the lasagna.
The vegetable lasagna.
Right. So you just blend those. And then you're going to roll out the dough here. Rolling out the dough. But then you're going to need a couple slices of toast for breadcrumbs, so let's just toast up a bit, shall we? Alright. Then you... okay. Alright, then you need roasted garlic.
Jonathan, is that your door?
No, I'm at the hospital. I thought maybe that was your door.
No, it's not my... I'm sorry, Travis, Jonathan, I have something to take care of. Excuse me, won't you?
Sure. Okay.
Benson? Benson?
Yeah, boss?
Benson, did you not hear the doorbell?
Doorbell? Sorry, boss, I has on my new headphones.
What are you listening to?
That unbelievable quadrophonic sound.
The doorbell has rung 3 times, Benson. Will you please answer it?
Sure enough, boss.
Excuse me. Now, gentlemen, where were we?
Boss, you got to get out here quick.
What is it now, Benson?
There's a squalling baby and an immigrant woman ain't from this nation, boss.
What? Jonathan, Travis, excuse me for a moment. Now, see here, madam. I must ask you to leave the premises.
Please, you must help. Immigration come to take my baby. No food. Please help. You take care of my baby. Goodbye.
Ma'am,
Boss, she just put that caterwauling youngin' in your arms and took off like a bat out of the unmentionable zone.
That's the problem with this country today, Benson. Too many immigrants abandoning their babies on strangers' doorsteps. What am I gonna do?
You best call the police.
Good idea, Benson. Call the police and get your friend Officer O'Malley on the phone.
All right. Hello, police?
Yes,
this is it, Officer O'Malley. Officer O'Malley, you best get over here right quick.
Benson! Oh, I'll be right over there.
A mean old immigrant woman done left her baby here on the... Oh, hold on, officer, sir. I got somebody at the door.
Well, hello, Benson.
Officer O'Malley, you is at the door and on the phone at the same time. Is you a spook?
No, no, no. I'm just on me two-way radio. Do you hear a bit of reverb? Can you hear the reverb? Do you hear the reverb? Benson, can you hear the reverb?
I best hang my phone up.
Benson, can you hear me? Hear me now. Now that's better.
Officer O'Malley, thank goodness you're here. I have an unwanted child.
Ah, tell me about it. I'm Irish Catholic.
Officer, my situation is dire and I need your help.
Well, let's see if we can find a caretaker for this baby at the Comedy Corner. There's a comedian down there who works blue. I best go make sure he's adhering to the decency laws.
Oh, great. Maybe we can unload this baby there. Vincent, go fire up speed buggy.
Sure enough, boss. Now, come on, you old car. You best start up for the boss.
I need oil.
You need oil? Here you go, old buddy.
All right. Everybody into the car.
Here we are at the comedy club.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, direct from the stinking stump waters and incestuous tar paper shacks of Tennessee, it's the Corn Pone Comedian!
Hey, how y'all doing tonight? Good. I just got back, man, from the gynecologist. I had to take my old lady down there. Man, she got something wrong with her. Her looks like a calzone folded in half. I tell you, man. I swear to God, her I tell you, man, Jesse Helms' ass smells better than her man. I had to go a calf a few days ago. Shit, man, I thought I was going to have to knock a wall out the trailer. I ain't got no insurance. She going to cost me $100,000 to take care of this shit, man. She must have slept some kind of dirty Portuguese or something. Dirty immigrants. Is that a immigrant baby over there in that audience? Man, you need to get that baby out of here. That baby don't need to be listening to me, even though that son of a bitch might not be able to understand English.
What's so funny about this? This is an unwanted child here in the audience.
I want him. I can take that little tan son out of him. I might be able to make 5 or 6 G's off that mother. Sell him into white slavery or something.
Slavery is bad. We're going to take this child down to the orphanage. Here we is at the orphanage. Michael Caine, what you doing at the orphanage?
I'm performing a great deal of abortions. You must be the new orphans we sent for. Guards, seize him!
Seize him!
No!
Seize
get your head off me!
Seize him!
Now, nurse, strap them down to the beds and hand me my ether-soaked rag. And don't forget the injections. Good night, you princes of Maine. Good night, you kings of New England.
Tall, could have used a few pounds. Tight pants, points, hollering down. She was a black-haired beauty with big dark eyes and points all her own, sudden way up high. Way up firm and high. Out past the cornfields when the woods got heavy. Out in the back seat of my 60 Chevy. Working on a night move, trying to make some front page driving news, working on a night move. In the summertime, some kind of fly song. We were just young and restless and bored, living by the sword. And we'd steal away every chance we could, back rooms and alleys on trusty wood. I used her, she used me, but neither one cared. We were getting our share, working on a night moon, trying to lose the awkward teenage blues, working on a night moon.
Jonathan, I thought I heard you say for a second. I can't.
Hello?
I couldn't make it. Then. Hello?
It's Jonathan. Fading in and out. It's like fading in and out.
That's nice.
Boy, that was a great musical segment, wasn't it, Travis?
It was fantastic. He was amazing.
You're right. We need to bring Gary Chappman out from the local animal shelter where you can adopt animals, cats and dogs, so they don't kill them.
That's great.
Hey, guys, I really appreciate y'all having me on here.
It's our pleasure to have you on here, Gary, and I'm so happy that you don't kill the animals.
I just wanted to know that's what Fancy Critters is about.
But I have a question. It's not very professional, but I am such a big fan of your wife, Amy Grant.
Oh, she's great.
She's talented.
She is fantastic.
She's beautiful.
She is amazing.
She can sing. She's incredible.
She really is.
I just wanted to ask you what it's like to be married to such a talented, beautiful
woman. Well, I'm really
here
to talk about Fancy Critters. What I'm saying,
this is what I really like about her.
We've been divorced.
She's able to marry her faith to her art, and that's rare.
Jonathan,
these days.
Amy is a very faithful woman.
And
Jonathan,
I went to her
here. I brought a kitten out.
Her Christmas show last Christmas.
Jonathan,
and she made everybody get out their keys, and it was like jingle bells.
Snowball, like I said.
And it felt like I was in a Winter Wonderland.
She does a country. I'll have a dog here that needs to be adopted.
So creative. I guess what I wanted to ask you is,
Jonathan,
does she still like cook dinner for you, even though she's shy?
Amy and I have been divorced for some time.
Jonathan,
I'm gonna bring a dog
so
out here. This dog is a mixed breed,
and yet
she's
obviously a good mother and a good wife, right?
Jonathan,
we've been divorced for some time. She's remarried. Not remarried now.
What is it that's kept your marriage together? Because you're both celebrities and you both work so hard.
Jonathan, she left him for Vince Gill.
This dog's name's Lucky.
You're kidding me. Vince Gill?
She left him for...
Oh, my God. I mean, if there's somebody I like almost as much as Amy Grant, it's Vince Gill.
And,
it's like,
that is cool,
like totally the best singer in country music.
I'm really here to talk about Fancy
Critters.
I mean,
that,
Gary, that must be embarrassing for you. I mean, to go through a divorce in such a public context
they have,
like
they've
that?
Had children.
Amy and I'm
did you guys
sure
do everything you could to try to save the marriage? I have a friend who's a marriage counselor.
We
and I can put you guys in contact.
No. I'm happily remarried. I love my wife now. And
gosh,
you know,
I cannot believe that must have been a scandal. And you must travel the same circles. Do you ever see them?
We don't see them on concert. Hey, let's get these animals out of here. I think they're having a bit of trouble.
Friend,
I appreciate
Gil,
Fancy Tails. We do. We're a non-kill.
Like your friend? Or
Fancy Tails is a non-kill organization.
I bet the Christian community just was totally up in arms over that.
We're a non-
big Christian. Hello? Gary, are you there?
Yeah. All right. Hello, it's me. I haven't seen you in a long, long time. Really? Definitely. I haven't heard from you in a long, long time. Hello. Hello. Oh, yes. Hello. Yes. Hello? Well, let's do that again. Hello? Yes, again. Hello? Hello. What? You got to be surely thou just. Really? Uh-huh. Okay, good thing. Hello.
What?
Hello? Yes, hello. What? I can't hear callers back. Thank you. Hello. What? Hello. It's time to end the show, folks. Right there.